Have you ever heard someone say, that's retarded, or that's so gay, or ugh, triggered? People rarely mean harm when they say these things, but for many, these words hurt. I'd like to focus on that last one, triggered. In case this is a new one for you, triggered means that something, a sight or sound, has simulated memory of a traumatic event. For example, for a veteran, a car backfire might bring back bad memories of combat. Now, however, this word has a new meaning. Now it's used as punchline. Some people proclaim they're triggered at the slightest inconvenience. This is usually followed by a mock seizure or something of that nature. It sounds childish, that's because it is. It may seem immature without even heard adults abusing the phrase. In this room right now, 1 in 4 people are struggling with mental illness. If you're part of that 25%, you know how hard it is. People with mental illness face job discrimination, higher mortality rates, and judgment on all fronts. You might be wondering, what can I do to help? As cliche as it may sound, you don't need to start with something big. Giving funds to organizations fighting for these people is great, but the best way you can help is to start with yourself and the language you use every day. It is nearly impossible to know with 100% certainty whether someone is struggling with a mental illness or not. Take, for example, my grandmother. Outwardly, she is one of the most composed people I know, and just from talking to her, you'd never guess that she's dealt with bipolar disorder, or OCD, or depression. For my project, I made a series of videos educating people on terminology surrounding mental illness and the abuse of it. Throughout the year and throughout my project, I learned just how hard it is to advocate for people. I found it hard to practice what I preach. If you're someone who's on the fence like I was, I have one word of advice. Be that person. Stand up. When you hear people abusing this terminology, say something. Don't worry about those who say, you're lame, or you must not be fun at parties. For those with mental illness, it makes a world of a difference. Your words have impact. Make them worth speaking. While educating yourself and those around you will completely eradicate the deeply rooted hatred and abuse of mentally ill people in our society, it will make things somewhat better for those afflicted. Speak up. Remember the power that your words have to help, not harm. Thank you.